backwards, silly girl.
Wait, wait, wait. Is this the wide angle? Hold on. Don't. I like that. I prefer that angle. So if you flip it at all.
Okay.
Flip it twice.
Win a renter.
What up? It's the trooper.
Hi, Alexander.
What up, everybody? Gil's hungry, but Gil, I don't know how the hell you think you want to eat this all the way over there. We weren't going to do this.
Oh, the light.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. Fix it.
Let me fix the lighting.
We got to fix the lighting. The studio is all up right now.
Is it this one? This one?
That one and the second one. Right.
Okay.
So we weren't going to do this today. I got to talk louder, too, by the way. That damn thing doesn't pick us up good enough. We weren't going to do this today. We had no plans of doing this, but we did have plans of cooking this pork loin. And then we were like, we should just do it live on YouTube. Are you sure I'm supposed to cut that off?
Yep, I'm positive.
On a pork loin, tenderloin?
Yeah.
You Google it. Can I Google it?
Yes, you could.
Okay. All right, everybody, come over here. Put the camera on me.
Oh, goodness.
Can I get some?
This way?
No.
Oh, this way. Oh, where's your apron?
Oh, I'm going to work on it. Every time I compliment you on your skills as the main camera lady.
Hi, Ari.
Should I remove silver skin from pork tenderloin? Oh, I forgot to mute this. Mute. Because it's tough, chewy, and doesn't melt during cooking like fat does, silver skin must be removed before cooking. Start by removing as much as fat as possible from the tenderloin. All right, so we're gonna do it. I don't like the idea of that. Why can't this shit be ready when I bought it?
Because we didn't get it from the butcher. The butcher is supposed to remove the silver skin.
You want an apron? Fine. You got an apron. Is there enough light?
Yeah.
Everything looks okay?
Yep.
Don't mess up, camera lady.
Oh.
Go gamble apron action. Coupon code APRON still works for 15% off everything except coffee at gogambleshop.com.
Hi, Justin.
So, Justin, as well as
Justin
the rest of
David.
As well as the rest of you, we decided to cook this pork tenderloin, but we also got some tortillas. And we also got some frijoles. So Christina is gonna make refried beans from these pintos we got going here. All right. And I am gonna cook this tenderloin.
Hi, Alex.
What up, Alex?
Hello, everybody.
Let me look.
Yeah.
All right.
And the glare,
Do we have enough light? Let us know if there's not enough light. I don't know how to do this. I've never cut silver skin off of anything before in my life, but I'm going to give it an attempt right now. You ready?
Yes, it is adjustable, the apron.
It's adjustable. Did somebody ask
Joel?
That?
Uh-huh.
Joel, check it out. I'm going to tell you two things, Joel.
Hi,
Joel.
Stephen Lake.
Shh. Joel. Just kidding. Joel, are you paying attention? Check it out. There's a black one and a white one. The white one is made of a more sturdier cloth that is more like, what would you call that? What would you say the white one is more like?
Oh, it's more of a, what is it, like a linen?
I don't know if I would like call that. It's a much sturdier cloth, and this doesn't slide in and out, but the black one is a little more silky, so it falls down like way easier. But check it, the string goes all the way through, so it's adjustable.
Hi, Cinnamon.
Good morning, Cinnamon. Good morning, everybody. Yeah.
Oh, we're saying good morning. Good evening.
You didn't say good morning.
I think I said good morning.
Yo, Kevin. Thanks very much, Kevin.
Thank you, Kevin.
Alvin says this looks like a wedding dress. Yo, I don't like it when the strings aren't even.
Oh.
They gotta be even. Look. So how do we do that? We go like this. How do I even my strings?
Just pull one.
I did.
No one's gonna pay attention to them.
I can feel it in the back.
Once that's in a bow?
That's what she said. I can feel it in the back.
Nasty.
Nasty. All right. It's the trooper.
When does discount code end?
Someone else. I think I put it till like Wednesday.
Okay.
All right. We got trooper. We got lady trooper on camera. I'll let you know.
Oh, yes. We did have the hazelnut syrup this morning.
We did have the hazelnut syrup today. And you know what? Christina made pancakes this morning and we put the hazelnut syrup on the pancakes. Speaking of the hazelnut syrup, there it is. What you know about hazelnut syrup? Homemade. We decided next time we're gonna make like macadamia or something that doesn't come with skins on it. Right? Okay. May 13th. I said it for the 13th. The apron discount is good for, it's not just for the apron though. It's for everything except coffee. Back to the point. How do you cut? Daniel Van Zandt wants banana pudding and he wants it now.
We'll get it to you, Daniel.
Daniel, how do you cut silver skin off of a pork loin? All right, here we go. I'm going in. You ready?
Yep, I'm ready.
I'm going in. First, I'm going to open this. I'm going in. I don't have enough light. I can't see shit.
You want me to put on the other light?
So what am I cutting off? Just a little bit of this fat?
No, well, that's fat.
Don't get in there.
Now, turn it around.
I'm going to turn it around.
Oh, see from right there?
All right.
Pull that.
Why don't I just go in right here where it's already open?
Kind of is. Slippery little sucker, huh?
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to spin it around.
Okay.
So I can get in like this. We're going to cut off.
There you go.
Silver skin action. Yeah, but look, I'm cutting away too much
meat.
You know, I'm like a damn, I got a little obsessive compulsive action going. I don't want to lose none of that meat.
You're going to lose a little bit of it.
Look at that. Silver skin. I've never done this before in my life. I don't like handling raw meat. I said it. I'm not a big meat handler, you know? As you can tell, I'm being a little too easy on the meat. I probably just need to whack it with the knife real quick.
Fine.
I'm serious.
Hi, Angela.
Hi, Angela. Who's Angela?
I don't know. It just says, it's Angela. She said, hi, troopers.
Wait, am I supposed to cut this off too?
No.
No?
No, you got all the silver skin off.
No, there's a big chunk right here.
Oh, wow.
All right. So I forgot to tell you one important thing, people. We decided to cook this pork loin, and then we decided to cook refried beans with it. And then we decided if we're going to cook pork loin and we're going to cook refried beans, then why don't we just make pork loin burritos? Pork tenderloin. Not pork loin.
Yeah, we didn't know what to make.
Yeah. Now, what do you do with this? Surely you don't put this in the trash can.
Ew. Yes,
that's
going to
stink like ass tomorrow morning. I'm not taking trash out tonight.
You got to take out the trash.
You can forget it. You know what? I didn't touch this with my right hand.
You didn't?
No. So I'm just going to go ahead and...
Hi, Hagen Tucson.
Could you? Hi, Hagen Tucson. We live again.
The jewelry business is going good. It's going okay. Thank you, everyone.
We got some extra virgin olive oil.
Yes.
Also known as EVO. Sometimes called EVOO. Now, what you want to do, right, is you want to stroke the meat with the oil. What? Get your mind out of the gutter, lady trooper. That is disgusting. Is that enough?
It looks like enough.
Do you even have to do that?
Well, it's to give it flavor.
No, I'm talking about brushing it.
Oh.
Rolling that bitch around like this.
Well, yeah, you want it coated.
All right.
Hello from Ohio.
I'm going to leave it crooked in there like that. All right, check it out.
Oh, there's already a troll 2 cent.
I got this stuff.
I'm trying to be more careful this time.
I got this Basari.
It's really good.
Seasoning.
Oh, uh-oh. Thank you, Coach Mo. Ordering coffee.
Yeah, thanks, Coach Mo. Hey, is this coming out fast enough?
Yeah? No. Okay.
Do it like this?
Yeah.
Flip her over. You know what? We're going to need those lights. I can't see Jack. All what right. Do you think?
We'll try not to be under them.
Yeah, just try not to be under them.
Is that better?
Yeah, I think so. All right, we got that pork tenderloin action going.
That looks pretty good.
Is that enough?
Yeah, that's enough.
You sure?
Remember last time the ribeye was a little salty?
Yeah, but...
That has...
Look at that hand. You see it? Good thing this is not my pimp hand. You see that?
Ew.
I'll tell you one thing. I'm not going to slap no ass with that hand until I wash it. All right. Oh, snap.
Oh, preheat the oven.
Yeah, do you want to preheat it while I go wash my hands?
Okay. People are saying...
Back up, brother. Back up, brother. People are saying what?
That the pork needs a lot of salt.
What the hell did I say?
It looks like there's a lot of seasoning.
We put a lot on there. Here, let me wash my hands. I'll be right back.
Hi, Dawn from Wisconsin. It looks pretty well seasoned, everyone, I think. Let me preheat the oven. $3.50. I believe we're gonna bake it at 350 for 20 to 25 minutes. Hi, Pete. I know, right, Bernard? Have Tim check speed of camera? We're using the phone, so it's not that good. It's not that clear, so it's a little jumpy.
What's that noise?
Nothing, I just preheated the oven.
I heard someone talking.
It's me talking to the people.
I heard a man's voice.
You, really?
Yeah, so here's the question. Hog and 2 cent is deceptive, could be deceptive. Is it hog or is it 2 cent? Or is it hog and 2 cent? You get it? Because it's one account. Who's out there typing? Who's out there watching?
I think usually when it's 2 cent, she puts at the end that it's her.
Oh, that's right.
Right? I gave him my 2 cents, moving on.
Jason says you do a great job with the camera.
Oh, thank you. I'm trying not to be too jumpy.
I gave him 2 cents, moving on. 2 cent, right. Is that enough salt?
I think so. It looks pretty good.
You want me to sprinkle a little kosher salt?
Hi, Vince. It? If you want, it's up to you.
It's going to be too salty?
Mm-hmm. I don't know.
I'll hit it with some of this.
Woo! Okay, that's enough.
That's more than enough salt. What? All right. Oven's preheating. What else? You want to cut some onion for you, yeah?
Oh, yes, please.
Is that all you got to cut?
Yeah.
Just the onion?
Just the onion.
That's it? I'm going to do this.
Yeah. I didn't have time to boil the beans. and make them from scratch. So these are canned
pinto beans.
Oh, we had time. We just happened to have canned beans sitting around. And then I don't even like beans unless they're refried anymore. Hey, listen, we forgot to tell you guys, Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day, everyone.
To all you mothers and all you mother. Sorry.
Oh my goodness.
I didn't say it. How much? How much?
Hola, Dark Angel.
Mas?
No.
This much?
Yeah. Probably too much. I probably just need half of this.
Well, tough ta-ta. That's all I can tell you. At this point.
You just cut it in half.
Really?
Yeah.
Really? That's all you need? Just that?
Yep. It's just to flavor the the olive oil.
Alrighty.
Oh, really?
Don't touch onion and then the phone, silly girl.
I used my pinky. Yeah.
What do you want me to do? Just cut it up in little tiny pieces?
Nope. Just like that. No.
What do you mean? Just like this?
It's just to flavor the oil and then I take it out of the oil.
Oh. You don't leave. Stop it. You are so crazy. Listen.
Oh, really? You're in the hospital? Sorry to hear that. He's watching us. Mike Petitroni?
Mike.
I'm sorry, I can't pronounce your last name.
Why are you in the hospital, Mike? Don't say COVID, please. Is that stuff bad or what? The COVID. All right. What's next?
Next, I'm going to start on the oil.
Do you want me to put this on?
Yes, please.
Here. Got this? How hot do you want it? Medium?
No, right there.
Right there?
That's perfect.
Okay.
And then I need a spoon.
Don't you need the masher thing? Oh, no, you like to use a spoon.
I like to use a metal spoon if we have one.
I don't think we have one.
Mashing beans. Well,
unless you want this kind.
Oh, no. I'll choose this one.
Is that okay?
This we'll have to do. Mashing beans with the bean mashers.
A pain in the ass? Wait.
It's not the authentic way. No. Silly.
That's not silly. That was a legit idea.
I thought we had a metal spoon. But this will do.
Look under here. What's going under here? What's going on?
That's everything we don't use. Okay, I'm going to put this onion. Is this all we use the cutting board for?
Yeah. I didn't know. I thought we were chopping onion.
Oh, you thought we were going to chop the onion and leave it in the refried beans?
Yeah.
No. Since we're not using lard, we have to give this avocado oil flavor.
We got avocado oil action going. And avocado oil is what is known in the business as a neutral oil. I just made that up.
You have it facing towards you?
Yeah.
Oh.
But it's true. It doesn't have any flavor. So that's what we were looking for here. So here, beans. There's no beans in there yet.
No.
So let's see. Oh. Oven's preheated. Are we putting it in right now or are we going to wait?
You want to wait until I get the beans rolling?
Yeah. Will the beans stay hot or what?
Yes, they'll stay hot, especially in this cast iron skillet.
Here, let's see if I can do something like this. This might be a genius plan. And it might be dumb as shit. We'll see. If you don't touch this, it'll work. Ah!
It takes a little while.
Bernard, I always do the dishes, Bernard. Because I like to do it. It's my favorite thing to do is do the dishwasher. Do you know what I mean? So this onion can go back, yeah?
Yep.
See, look. See the screen?
I like it. Good setup.
That's what's doing. Whoa.
Now you could read all the chat and see what I go through trying to get everything.
Yo, Brad.
Now you're in charge.
Anthony. Alexander. Craig. Oregon Adventure. Andre. Everybody. What up? It's the Trooper. Lady Trooper making refried beans. I got a camera stationary all set up for her right now. You know, we could use the damn tripod, couldn't we? Ah!
Onions are smelling so good. Why, this works fine. I said, this works fine. It's a good shot of the onion.
Someone said, why cook food with no flavor? But sometimes you don't want a strong flavored oil for whatever you're doing.
Well, we didn't want to use lard. We're trying to be more heart healthy.
No, not me. I don't give a shit. I'll eat all the lard. Give me the lard. I'll eat it.
I know.
And it smells good.
It does, huh?
Really? That's just flavor in the oil?
I usually put a corn tortilla in here and let it get almost burnt. And that gives a good flavor. I don't know if anyone's made refried beans, but that's the authentic way to do it.
I don't know.
They burn the tortilla in the oil to get it a toasty flavor.
Really?
Yeah.
No jokes. We don't like laughing around this mother.
Is that Dale? He's been wanting to tell a joke for a while.
Cast iron is great to make refried beans, said Craig. Hey, Craig. Craig and Craig. Oh, Hagen 2 cent. Thanks very much. Happy Mother's Day to all the moms out there. Gotta run, but we appreciate these lives. Thanks, 2 cent.
Oh, thank you.
And Hog. Got them refried beans action going. There's no beans in there yet, though.
Almost. Almost ready. Almost there.
They're saying to sear the tenderloin first.
I told you, but remember?
A couple people said that. A couple recipes, but... If you wanted, you could.
Too much trouble. We're going to put it in a burrito.
That's true.
We're going to put it in a burrito anyway. You know what, Oregon Adventure? I was just thinking that.
Make some coffee. Can I use this to put the onion on?
Here, let me...
The onion is... That's it.
Are you going to have coffee again?
No way.
You know what? It doesn't matter. Here.
It's 7:20.
Here.
Too late for coffee.
Too late for you for coffee.
For me, yeah.
I don't know about everybody else around here.
Okay, now... See how they're brown?
You want me to get it out?
No, I got it.
You know how to do it? You know what, Poker Career? I don't think I ever liked the band Black Flag necessarily. Black Flag. We're gonna have a TV party tonight. All right. We're gonna have a TV party, all right. Tonight. Cause we got nothing better to do. Then watch TV and have a couple of brews. That's all I know. You sure you got enough Earl?
Yep. Okay, you ready? This is going to be messy.
What's going to be messy? Are you serious?
Yeah.
Why you got to be messy? Don't be messy. Wait, you don't need the juice right now, do you?
No, I don't.
Oh, I see what you're... Here, hold on. Let me get this out of your way.
Okay.
Or no.
I need the spoon.
You need the spoon? All right. I'm gonna put the spoon in the juice. All right, kids, here we go. Hold on, let me do this. I'm gonna get a closer angle. All right, now. Get them. Here, wait. All right, go. That's not that messy.
A little messy.
No way.
It splatters everywhere.
Oh, Lord. You didn't tell me it was messy.
Well, you wanted refried beans.
I got cans of refried beans, yo. Refried beans with the troopers. The hazelnuts aren't ready yet. We're still working on that. Ah, I lied. It's just been ready. Huh. It's over there. See it on top of the sugar? Oh, yeah. Yo, there's oil everywhere, my brother. Hold on. Hold on. In my cup?
Yeah.
Maybe.
They're looking beautiful.
Refried beans. Cooking in the pan.
This is the first time I made them for you, I think.
Yeah. Who's going to clean up all this damn oil all over the floor? I'm going to slip and break my damn neck. Holy shit, you really are frying them.
Yeah.
You're really frying them. You're really frying those beans. All right, what am I doing? Oh yeah.
Oh, iced coffee.
Yeah, let me set
my- You want me to hold it for you?
Yeah.
I can hold it, because I just-
Don't get oil all over it.
No, I won't.
All this damn thing's on there tight because it was sticky.
Oh.
All right, you ready?
Yeah.
Get a little of this going.
Oh, they're getting nice and toasty.
Get the camera.
Girl, I'm showing them the beans. This is the main course.
You're right. When do we put the pork in?
Oh, you can start putting the pork in now.
All right, give me this. All right, the pork's going in the oven. Pork loin burrito action. Can you open the oven? I'm not searing it. I know everybody. It should be seared, but I ain't searing shit. It's too much trouble, and I'm putting it in a burrito.
It's just not going to look as pretty.
We don't care how it looks.
And then 25 minutes?
Yeah. I'll check it at 20 minutes.
So now
she said, I left this in here earlier. We got all this first person action going. First person. River King loves refried beans.
Oh, good. Okay, now we're gonna put in the juice.
There is a good point though. Searing it. It will help it to not be dry. What you doing?
Now we're putting the juice in.
This is dangerous activity. All the juice?
All the juice.
The juice is loose.
It kind of deglazes the pan. So all those.
Oh, it does?
Yeah. All those toasty pieces of the bean.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Go ahead. Okay.
So then you let it simmer for like 5 or 10 minutes. We don't smash them yet.
No?
Nope. You gotta let the juice kind of thicken.
Juice? Haven't you seen my movies?
Oh, goodness.
Juice?
Let me move this out of your way.
Okay. Okay, coach.
Want me to hold that for you?
Please, por favor. Gracias, amiga.
De nada.
Gracias.
We could.
What do I call you?
Chiquita?
Oh. You're not a banana.
Bonita?
I forgot what I was doing. I hit her with that. What happened? Oh, you know. What you doing?
I'm trying the juice.
Juice?
Oh, those need some salt.
Listen, we know we're not a cooking show. Ha! That rhymed. But we have fun live streaming on the thing. for the people to watch the thing?
Yes, Eric, I learned it from my family.
Did you know that we put up a new video today? Oh, I need water in this hoe.
Which one's salt? This one?
Babe, there's avocado oil everywhere up in here.
I know.
Which one's
salt? Is this kosher salt?
No, that's sugar. Are you crazy?
Oh, here's the kosher salt.
Here, let me get it for you. What you need?
I need a sprinkle.
You don't want pink salt?
No. Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, that should be fine. If these beans are salty, you're in trouble. You're going to have to go to the nearest Mexican restaurant.
There was only like 6 grains left in my hand.
I haven't started smashing them yet.
Smash this.
Oh, Ben Barry said, Senorita. Is that what you call me?
Senorita. No, that's not what I want to call you. I want to call you, what's mijo?
Why, I am a senorita.
What is mijo?
Huh?
Mijo, what is that?
That's a boy.
No, it's not.
Yes, mijo is son.
So, mija, that means daughter?
Yeah.
No, I don't want to call you that. So.
What plan for video ideas when things open back up again? That's what Aaron asked.
All kinds of pornos. Just kidding. I don't like these things.
I fill them up too much?
No, I just can't get the daggone ice out. I don't know.
Oregon Adventure wants to know if you still play poker online.
Not too much. I get frustrated. I like to play Heads Up Super Turbo Sit and Goes. I was playing that earlier already. Can you handle the camera and the beans?
Yep, I can multitask. Beans are looking good. They're not burning.
All right, we got the...
Oh, we got the ice trays at...
Target. They're over there in the bartender section. Like there's in the kitchen section, there's like bar stuff over there.
When is our trip to Florida? Everything's on hold right now.
Yeah, who knows? We don't want to go to Florida, right? We don't want to go pay money to go on a trip when things aren't like open and running like normal, you know? We want to be able to have fun when we go to Florida or wherever we go. Cool beans. Ha 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 ha
ha ha ha ha ha ha. What laugh is that?
Somebody made a jokey joke. He said cool beans.
Oh.
You know what I'm thinking?
What?
Shout out Jack Potter. I feel like we should open up an iced coffee joint. Iced coffee only and call it cool beans.
I like that idea.
Everybody has fun when they go to Vegas. Spark Man, the coffee is fabuloso. Trust me on that. Got that Go Gamble blend action right there. Always. All right, the beans are boiling.
Okay, I'm gonna start smashing them.
There's avocado oil everywhere up in here.
No one said Mexican food is neat.
Hi, Jojo.
Jojo Starbucks. No?
Yep. Look at all the steam rolling out of there.
Oh, wow.
Steam action.
Well, you want me to help you with your ice?
Nope.
Okay. I'm going to lower it and start smashing them.
All right, Christina's going to smash the beans.
I'm going to hold it.
Nope. Okay. I am going to set you up. Oh, gee whiz, Louise. Jeez, Louise. What happened?
What do you mean?
Oh, I flipped the camera around again like a dummy.
This is how my grandmother used to do it. The back of a spoon.
Your grandmama did it?
Yeah. Not with a potato masher or beans.
All right, watch Christina make the beans while I complete the iced coffee operation. Too many hands. We don't have enough hands. Too many hands needed. You guys are sitting on top of the coffee maker right now. I could see that damn thing falling any second. That's not going to be fun.
You said no cheese, right?
I wouldn't think so.
Okay. Just cheese when you make your burrito?
Yeah.
Okay.
Don't you think?
Mm-hmm. I like them like semi-smashed. Not all the way, right? Not all the way.
Whatever you want. Whatever you want is good with me. I like them both ways. I would say 75 to 80% smashed. I hate that fucking thing. Excuse my language. Uh-oh. I hate it.
Timothy's getting upset.
Lord have mercy. Well, it wouldn't have been that bad, but I think I put too much cream in the coffee.
Uh-oh. I'll drink it.
Too much cream in the coffee. Damn. Smash them, yo. Smash them beans. Mash them up, playa. All right, here. Let me give them something interesting to look at. That would be me putting ice in the coffee. So if you're just tuning in, we had the idea of cooking this pork loin. Are we making it the best possible way you can make a pork loin? No, we're not. We didn't sear it, okay? But it's gonna be good because we're gonna put it in burritos. We're making pork loin burritos. In the meantime, while Christina makes the refried beans, the homemade refried beans, I need a nice coffee. That's if you're just tuning in. If you're not just tuning in, carry on. Right? Made this with the hazelnut syrup that we made last night. Homemade hazelnut syrup. Right? Let's see what's happening. I didn't put no syrup in it.
Wow, that's a miracle.
Oh, we're resumed.
Do they look darker now?
Thanks, Johnny, if you can hear me. Yeah, they do. I was just talking nonsense. Oh, those look good. Here, let me, that won't work, will it? Try to put them in the cabinet. I need more scissor in the coffee. Got that homemade hazelnut syrup we made last night. Yeah. So if you're looking for a recipe, oh, look at that. Ari asked, just as I was about to say, if you're looking how to make the hazelnut syrup, watch our video that we made last night. We did it live. We roasted hazelnuts, then we peeled them the best we could. Then we put the sugar in the water in the pot, dissolved it, put the hazelnuts in, and let it cook for 45 minutes. No echo. I don't know nothing about no echoes. As long as this thing is muted over here, which I think it is. What about this live stream action? Hola, Marcelo. Johnny can hear us. Ari's gonna watch and make some hazelnut syrup.
12 minutes left.
12 minutes, huh? I think in 7 minutes I should take a look at it. How's it looking there?
looking good. I could smell it.
Can't really see much. I'm gonna open it up. Screw it. Oh, it's not cooked yet, that's for sure.
Oh my goodness, it's cooking really slow.
Trooper Thursday soon. Thanks, Ben Berry Perry. The hazelnut syrup cost about $7 because we got a half a pound of hazelnuts, a little less than a half a pound, and they were $10.49 a pound. So it was a little less than $5 for the hazelnuts, and then we used about, I'm estimating about $1.75 worth of sugar. I do sell aprons. Check it out. Go Gamble. GoGambleShop.com. You can use coupon code APRON and get 15% off of everything except coffee. What do you got going there?
They're ready. All done.
They're done?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Refried beans. Made from scratch.
You want to try them? Oh, they're going to be too
Daniel's hot. On his way from, whatchamacallit, for some daggone banana pudding and iced coffee, so you better get your shit together. Ha! Oh. All the way from Iowa. JoJo Starbucks likes the apron. It's adjustable, JoJo Starbucks. Hey, Ronnie. It's adjustable. The string runs all the way through, so it goes up and down. You know what I'm talking about? Oh, you want the camera?
You want? No, I was gonna ask if you want to try some.
The beans?
Yes.
They're boiling. Are you trying to burn my mouth off? What's all this tasting spoon bullshit? We're the only two people to live here. Just let me eat it right off the spoon. That's too much. Are they salty?
No.
Ha!
They're actually perfectly seasoned.
She thought I put too much salt.
Blow on it!
What do you think?
They taste like pinto beans.
Do they taste good?
Yeah!
That's all that matters.
They taste damn good!
Next time we'll make them with lard and then you'll see the difference.
Okay.
And the tortilla I was missing.
Sup, everybody. I just made these refried beans from scratch. Just kidding. Christina made the beans, frijoles, fritos.
Oh, really, Gavin? His sister made him carrot cake. He doesn't think it was as good as Christina's carrot cake.
Well, that's probably true. It's hard to beat Christina's carrot cake.
I don't have an apron.
Yeah, where's your apron? It's downstairs.
Next time.
It's too late now, huh? Dang. I didn't even think of that.
You could make some bean burritos. We could.
You hear that sizzling?
Have some carne asada.
Is that sizzling?
It's sizzling.
Is it gonna cook?
I hope so. I hope so. Then all we have to do is warm up the tortillas. I don't have a comal.
Is that my fault?
Yes.
Oh, I left the damn thing on, huh?
Some salsa. Yeah, the beans are off the fire, River King.
This says 25 minutes per pound. How much do you think that thing cost? I mean, how much do you think that thing weighs?
I told you to check the package.
No, you didn't.
Yep.
You told me after I threw the package away.
Oh, thank you, Gerald. He just ordered his chef apron.
Oh, thanks.
Pork tenderloin is in the oven.
Poink tenderloin?
I know.
Can I eat these onions?
Sure.
Really?
If you want to. Ew, they're just fried onions. Ew.
It tastes good. It tastes like a bad onion ring.
Yuck.
All right.
It's pretty simple. Pork tenderloin burritos.
Yep.
Uh-oh, someone said that pork would take about 45 minutes to an hour at 400 degrees. It looks like it's cooking really slow, huh?
I know, right? What's going on with that?
Oh, how many pounds did you say? Oh.
I don't know.
He already threw the package away.
Do you want me to dig it out?
No.
I'm going to dig it out.
Alexander said to check the package. I think that's like 1 pound. It should be on the other side of it. There you go.
It's 1.14 pounds. So it should take like, it should be 25 minutes per pound at 325.
Oh, all the recipes I saw said 350.
Yeah, well, 1.1 pound, 350. I mean, it should work.
It should. I hope. I know, we're not going to open the oven anymore.
I got to wash my hands now. I just dig in the trash can.
Someone said it's going to be cooking slow because we didn't brown it first. You know, because when you brown it, you get it started cooking in the pan. And right. Then you finish it in the oven.
Right.
Someone said we could turn up the oven up to 400 degrees.
Yeah.
River King.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but does River King know what the hell he's talking about?
I don't know.
River King, no offense, all due respect. Do you know what the hell you're talking about?
Yeah, it's cooking really slow. We'll see. We could pump it up.
Pump it up.
In 5 minutes, if it doesn't look like it's cooking, look, we could pump it up to 400 degrees. What about that? That could be a plan.
What?
I said in 5 minutes, because we put the timer for 25 minutes.
Why do you want to wait 5 minutes? Let's do it now. Pump it up. Take River King's advice.
He said yes. When you asked him, yeah. Do you know what you're talking
River
about?
River King, I'm going to pump it up. Pump it up.
DMS, Tim didn't want any vegetables too.
How do you do it? You can't change the temperature of the oven in the middle?
No, I think you got to. All
right, cancel, bake.
There you go.
Start?
Yeah.
River King. Is that who it said?
Yes, we have a thermometer.
We do have a thermometer, kind of,
yeah. It'll come out good. The beans will mask the dryness if it's dry.
It's going to be good.
We got a lot of beans if the pork tenderloin isn't good.
You know what we could do?
Beans, tortillas, and salsa.
Why don't we play a Super Turtle Heads Up single while we wait?
All right. I think they want to... River King said yes. I'm sure they want to see you play.
Let's play a Super Turbo... Damn, this thing says 3 minutes left.
Brandon said, what did he say? One thing either of you missed during this pandemic.
Put the camera away from me.
Oh.
You got it away? Am I in a shot?
No, you're not.
All right, put it back on me. There might be some slick ass people that can see my password.
Oh. I'll hold the camera while you're playing. Oh. You don't want to sit... Oh, I was going to say, you don't want to sit down?
Now.
Don't put it on you yet.
Get off that woman.
Oh, did you raise your hand at me?
No. All right, check it out. Whoops. Sorry. Now you can get... Now you're closer. Here, I'll hold it. All right, let's play. What do you call it? Look, they can see you. Let's play a Super Turbo. Let's play Super Turbo. A $10 Super Turbo heads up signal while we wait for the pork. Can you keep an eye on the pork? Don't be dirty. That pork in the oven.
Funny.
Oh, we got action. Oh, you know what? What if this guy's watching? Raise it up.
He's gonna see your cards.
Oh, he re-raised. Let's put it in. Call. Oh, all right. This was a bad idea. I could get a 9. Bing. Oh, I won. I got lucky. Yep, I got lucky. What beat? Oh, the preheat of the oven. Did everybody see that? Did everybody see me get lucky? Nobody saw me get lucky? Nobody's even talking about it?
Aw.
That's all right. I just got lucky, that's all. Where's the chat? Oh, I turned it off. What a dummy. Ronnie, we're making pork tenderloin. We're gonna make burritos out of it. And Christina made homemade refried beans. Whoops.
Now you're gonna do a dance for us?
No.
You gotta entertain us for another 5 minutes.
Oh, you almost forget I had coffee. You wanna taste it? It tastes real good. Real nice. It tastes real nice, don't it?
It does taste good.
Hazelnut. Yo, I think it might be ready.
No way.
Hey, take a look at it. Come take a look at it. You're telling me that's not ready?
No, they're not ready.
Alright. It's pork. It's gonna have a pink color.
River King just said don't open until oven until done. You will lose 25 degrees every time you open it. When time expires, use thermometer to check internal temperature. My wife says I'm the best cook.
Okay, well, we're supposed to be cooking at 350. It's at 400, so now we're at 375.
So
what do you want me to do?
I'll just say 5 more minutes.
Alright, I'm gonna put a 5-minute timer.
And then,
I need a solid, hard recipe. I don't need all this guesswork.
Then you can stick the thermometer in. You want to?
What temperature do we want the pork? All right, look over here.
Know what, River King?
We need to cook it to 145.
Yeah.
Followed by a 3-minute rest. It's hassle-free and doesn't take long to cook. Pork.org. It says here. $145 to $160 with a 3-minute rest. How to cook it. I should have looked at this before we started.
River King said, yeah, before you said that, he said, you're looking for 160. And then someone else said it should be 145 to 150.
And this is 145 to 160.
Okay. So I guess 145 is like the safe zone. That's what they call it.
145. So
that's the least,
right?
Yeah.
It only takes 20 minutes on a direct medium hot grill for a few minutes more if roasting in the oven, 400 degrees. If grilling pork tenderloin, it only takes 20 minutes on a direct medium hot grill. A few minutes more if roasting in the oven, 400 degrees.
I know, Lynn.
What did Lynn say?
Too many cooks in the kitchen.
Too many cooks in the damn kitchen right now. I agree.
Too many chiefs?
Will my coffee thermometer work?
I don't know. You should put it on. Ask Google.
Can I use a milk thermometer for pork?
Oh, DMS. Wow. He's making blackened catfish tomorrow. Yum. I've never had catfish. I know, Maddie, right?
A candy thermometer? The hell's that?
Those are the ones that you stick to the side of the pan, like when you're making fudge or caramel.
Oh, yeah. Can I use a milk thermometer for meat? Dark Angel said that's exactly how you do it. What's it? What is that about?
No sé.
No sé.
It goes too fast sometimes.
All right.
Oh, that's where you are, Daniel? Iowa?
Iowa.
Fresh fish. I haven't fished since I was a kid.
This floor is slippery.
So I'm gonna hear you eat it.
Avocado oil everywhere.
I don't know where Chris is. OMC, where are you?
Yeah, where's Chris? He wasn't here last night either.
Someone said you could use that thermometer, the milk thermometer.
Yeah.
I just don't want to overcook it. That would be horrible.
Well, it's about to hit 5 minutes right now.
Oh, wow. That passed by fast.
I know. I mean, didn't I have another one?
I thought you did. Hello, Canada. Let's see. I didn't have one?
We'll use this.
Okay.
In 24 seconds, I'm going to check it.
Okay.
How am I going to keep that shit from squirting all over me?
I don't know.
All right, you know what? Let's check it. Thermometer action. Come on inside.
Let me go.
Yeah.
Still looks bloody, but I don't know. I don't want to.
Keep going. Keep going. Keep going.
I'm trying to not to get it. Is it? What did it say?
150.
Oh, it said 150?
It said right at between the green and the red.
Oh.
It's 150.
Okay.
So, I'm taking it out.
So take it out and let it rest for 5 minutes.
3 minutes. Making a damn mess, yo. This is why I don't like cooking. It is.
What are you gonna go back to? Lasagnas?
Hell yeah, frozen. I'm gonna eat them frozen too.
We pulled it out. We're scared. We don't want to overcook it.
Well, it's 150 degrees in the middle right now.
Someone says we could,
It was still,
We could put foil on it and tent it.
It was still going up, too. I believe it probably would have hit like 155.
Okay.
It was still moving up.
All right. Do you want to tent it?
No. That sounds like an awful lot of trouble. I'm not here for a camping trip.
Oh, my goodness.
You know what I'm talking about, fellas?
He doesn't want to cover it with tin foil.
That's a lot of trouble.
Too much trouble for the man.
This shit is tiring. All this damn cooking we're doing?
It is tiring.
Get off that. Look at you. You make a mess.
so many, you have so many rules.
I ain't got no rules. It's got Earl all over it, though. I was just trying to tell you I got oil all over it. Whoa, watch that knee, lady. I don't like the dimness in here. I like all the lights. Listen, listen to me, everybody.
Listen, Linda.
Look at Linda. I know that's not pretty. I know it doesn't look good.
It's just a little pale.
But it's going to taste good, don't you think?
No, we never grill outside. It's either too hot or too cold.
Yeah, that's an extra pain in the ass.
See, the searing would have got it a better color.
Yeah, but who cares about the color? I'm slapping it in a burrito.
I just hope it's done, that's all.
Oh, it's done. You can believe that. It's 150 something degrees inside, babe.
Oh, people are saying we could sear the outside of it if we wanted to.
Yeah, we could.
We could. I'm sure it'll be fine. Oh, you timed it?
Yep.
3 minutes? 4 minutes?
It's been out there for at least, it was out there for at least a minute, and I put it on 3 minutes.
Okay.
How's everybody doing? How's everybody doing this Mother's Day? We have an egg and grilled a pork loin a month ago. Wow. 145. The Pork Association says 145 to 160.
And we pulled it out around 150, huh?
150. It was more than 150.
Because it was still going?
Yeah.
So we're having pork tenderloin and refried beans.
In a burrito.
Heat
these up?
No, heat the...
Oh, yeah, that.
For the tortillas.
Right.
In the pan. I don't have a...
These need to be heated again?
We can put it on low. All the way on low. We just can't forget it.
Yeah.
Remember last time we forgot? And we left the stove on?
Yeah.
Slice very thin. What's for dessert? No dessert.
Yeah, no dessert. Ain't nobody got time for that.
We'll find out when you cut into this puppy.
Listen.
The juices are running clear, so I think it's done.
I want it to be like juicy. Medium anyway, medium rare even. Right?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it.
Okay.
Tell you what, I'll use this guy.
Oh, the plate?
Should I just put it on here or a plate?
No, you can put it on there.
I forgot about that. It's definitely done. You can tell by the way it feels when you grab it. Oh, you think it's funny? Do you?
No.
Yeah, you do. It looks like you do.
Oh, ready? Is our oven turned off? River King reminded us. River King, are you a chef? I'll warm up the tortilla while you're...
I'll put that in there for the moment. Let's cut it and see what happens.
Okay, let me put the tortilla in there. Ah. All right.
Oh, it's definitely done.
Oh, that's definitely done.
It's probably too done.
It looks juicy.
It looks really juicy. Look at that.
Try it. Oh, wow. It's dripping wet. Don't burn yourself. Is it too salty or anything?
It's damn close to being overcooked.
Oh, wow.
But it's not. It's good.
It's perfect, River King said. It's perfect.
Yeah.
Oh, look it. Yeah, there is slight pink, which is fine.
Of course. This is the wrong knife.
Oh, shoot. You don't have to cut all of it. You could just...
No, I know. I was just cutting it up.
Looks really good. Do you want some jalapenos?
I don't think I do.
No? Cholula?
I'll probably put some Cholula. You know?
I'm warming up your tortilla. Wow, that's really good. Good job.
Yeah, another 2 minutes, it would have been dryish.
Good thing we took it out right away.
And if we seared it, it would be more juicy than it is.
Yeah.
I know. We just didn't want to go through all that trouble.
Oh, really, River King? He grew up cooking refried beans at an early age. Okay, your tortilla is ready.
Oh, yeah?
It's going to be really hot.
Oh, it is?
Yeah. When it starts bubbling up. Can you get that?
Oh yeah, I can get that.
Gonna make your burrito.
Really, a pork tenderloin burrito? I don't even know if that makes sense, does it?
I don't know. Well, we didn't have potatoes to make mashed potatoes or anything. Some cheese.
Some cheese.
Yeah, manteca. River King is the best. You need that, the pork flavor for the refried beans, that's for sure. Huggin' 2 Cent left. Someone's asking about Huggin' 2 Cent.
Yeah, they were here earlier. They gone.
Are you going to put salsa?
No, I don't think so. One more little piece, I think.
Oh, I've never had enchilada pie, River King. Nothing spicy? I need something spicy in mine.
You know what? Why not? Go with this.
I'm scared of the salsa.
Cholula.
Do we have arroz con pollo? Do we have tapatio too? Or another salsa or just Cholula?
Sweet Baby Ray's.
Oh, okay.
Look at it. Now respect.
Kyle says hello. Kyle Inkman.
What up, Kyle Inkman?
How was it?
That is a damn fine burrito.
Do you think it would be better with the salsa?
Mm-mm.
No?
Mm-mm. I don't think it could be better. You should be eating the first one, though.
Oh, shoot. It's okay. I'll eat second. You had to try it.
Es bueno. Muy sabroso.
I think I'm going to put some salsa on mine.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
Ready?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you're going to show me making mine?
Yeah.
I like to smear it.
I smeared mine a little bit.
There.
They told you to put salsa on yours.
Okay, I'll put salsa on mine. I like cheese on the beans.
Mm-hmm.
And then... Gosh, this pork looks so juicy.
It's good.
Okay. Let me get a spoon. go. I do want my cheese melted though. So.
It'll melt. Oh, you're gonna put it in?
To melt my cheese.
All right.
Gerald said, burritos and pajamas go together. Don't ask me why. Burritos and pajamas. Oh, look at, see? I got a little toastiness on my burrito.
Oh, yeah.
Got a little crunch. That way it'll melt my cheese.
Nice. Oh, yeah.
I could make you one like it. Or you want mine?
No. You eat that.
Okay, well, I gotta wait. I don't want to burn myself.
Yo, really good burrito with pork loin. And that pork loin only cost $6.50 at Trader Joe's. And it was like plain, it didn't have anything on it. We should have seared it, but it's all right.
Really good with the salsa.
Yeah. You like it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Does that taste good?
And the cheese is melted.
Nice.
Really good.
Burritos with the troopers.
Thank you everyone for tuning in.
Yeah, thanks everybody for tuning in to the thing. You know what? I'm going to have another one because why not? And yeah. Of course, Lynn. What's up, Malcolm? All right, it's been fun, but it's 8:11 on a Sunday night. We're going to watch Breaking Bad. Or who knows, maybe not. Maybe we'll get in the car and head to the airport. You'll find out later which one we chose. Remember, if you like our videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below.
See you next time.
See you next time.